Hello.
Do you want to know something? I'm not happy living at home anymore. To give you some context, I came back home to England to live with my parents in mid-March. And I love my parents. I get along with them so well. We make great housemates. And I'm so grateful to have been able to stay in their comfortable home during lockdown and for the past 6 months. But I'm no longer happy here. Why? Because nothing is challenging me here. Life is too easy here.
But I'm a strong, independent woman, and I don't like settling for easy.
I'm not going to grow by being comfortable. And whilst I am saving money here, yes, of course, I'm not learning anything by staying in my family home. And so I have decided it's time to move out. For a place to rent, I immediately started searching in London. I absolutely love London. I love the vibe, the culture. I wasn't particularly fussy about the location, as long as it was fairly central and had good transport links. I began making requests on Spare Room, speaking to estate agents, watching countless virtual viewings. One of my best friends, Shu, recently moved into her own gorgeous studio flat in London, and that was massively inspiring me as well. I decided my absolute maximum budget would be £1,200 per month, which is a lot for me, but I thought it would be worth it if it was the perfect place. Now, the problem is, London is so expensive that not even £1,200 per month would even slightly get me the perfect place. I started to have this horrible feeling inside of my stomach, the thought of throwing away that much money every month on a place I wasn't completely besotted with. I can't do it. But that's not to say I'm going to give up. No, no. What I'm now thinking is, what can that same amount of money get me elsewhere? So I immediately started looking into Portugal. I've never been to Portugal, but it's somewhere which I've really grown an interest in over the past year. I have a few friends in Portugal, and the flights are really cheap to get there too. I began to look at accommodation, and the accommodation prices were much more reasonable. The weather would be warmer there, I could work on my surfing. The only downside for me personally is that they speak Portuguese, and I'm quite balls deep into learning Spanish at the moment. But I thought, it's okay, I will slowly make my way down the country and then shimmy myself into Spain, where I can really nurture my skills. I told my mum and dad that I was moving to Portugal, and they were like, oh, really? And I was like, yeah. And they were like, oh, okay. So then I was this close to booking my flight when I was simultaneously scrolling through Instagram stories and saw that my friend Jord had just arrived in Mexico. And I was like, wait, Mexico? I messaged him immediately with 100 questions. How was your flight? Was it hard to get in? What's it like there right now? Because here were the bells that were ringing in my head. The weather is hot in Mexico. I like hot. The nature and the ocean are insane in Mexico. Big thumbs up. The prices are cheap in Mexico. I'll definitely get something within my budget. They speak Spanish in Mexico. That's the language I'm learning. And I'm like freaking out right now because suddenly everything makes sense. I'm moving to Mexico, bitches.
ass pool.
Yeah, baby!